условия на все по-разрастващи се съмнения за изхода от гръцката дългова криза в Атина се проведе 15-та кръгла маса с гръцкото правителство, организирана от списание «Economists». Икономисти, финансови експерти, политици, бизнесмени, учени и журналисти от цял свят в продължение на два дни дискутираха ще успее ли Гърция да проведе жизнено важните реформи и да избегне преструктурирането на дълга си в една изключително неблагоприятна външна среда.
Spreads have gone up. They have been very high. But let me remind you that in the second quarter, in the third quarter of last year, when the program started delivering results, spreads were coming down significantly by some 350 basis points for a few months, until a debate in Europe about restructuring and public sector involvement started to unsettle the markets and expectations, and quickly lost all this improvement in spread. Undoubtedly, it is now a question of whether Greece will be able to go back to the market as assumed next year. And this is something we're discussing right now. We obviously, in order to go ahead with the program, we need some reasonable assurances that the program is financed. This is something that's in discussion, and I should not go into this here. Second, already last year, there was evidence that on the fiscal adjustment that was beginning to run a little bit ahead of the underlying structural change. What do I mean about this? We saw that there was significant shortfall at local level, at spending overrun at local levels, hospital for instance. There was an accumulation of arrears, non-payment by the public sector. It was all offset, and it has so far continued to be offset by underspending, under-execution of spending at the state level. So overall targets were met, but in a way that is clearly not sustainable in the long run. To continue to have this deficit reduction, it's therefore essential that there is a significant acceleration of structural reform in the public sector. Enterprise reform, reform of healthcare, reform at all levels of government, reform of employment, reform of the wage grid, etc. We are in a situation where if we do not get this acceleration of structural reform, the deficit will get entrenched at where it is now, around 10%. We are not going to get much below 10% without these structural reforms.
И другият представител на институциите от надзорната тройка бе категоричен.
Returning to sustainable fiscal positions requires significant further fiscal consolidation efforts, especially in countries with large external deficits and high levels of indebtedness. But this call for fiscal discipline applies more widely in all countries. The implementation of strong fiscal consolidation efforts is required, and effective rules need to be adopted to anchor fiscal prudence in overall budgetary decisions in the future. Both competitiveness and fiscal sustainability should be supported by higher productivity growth. That implies that structural reforms should be targeted to remove remaining rigidities in the labor and product markets. In recent years, the progress with respect to structural reforms in euro area countries has overall clearly been disappointing and not commensurate with the requirements of participating in a common currency area. The Europe 2020 strategy for jobs and growth may provide the institutional framework at the European level for ambitious progress with respect to structural reforms. These policy requirements gain particular urgency in those countries currently receiving EU IMF financial assistance. The policy conditionality associated with these programs has been designed to address the main imbalances and the vulnerabilities in these countries, taking into account the specificities of the individual countries. Full compliance with the policy functionality of the assistance programs is absolutely essential. Full compliance means the implementation of the measures one to one as agreed between the Troika institutions and the authorities in the respective countries. This is absolutely essential to unwind imbalances and restore market confidence. And to restore market confidence is the key objective of these programs. Turning to the necessary policy response at the European level, the reinforcement of the fiscal rules and the introduction of a new surveillance framework for macroeconomic imbalances are necessary elements in strengthening overall economic governance in the euro area. On this objective to strengthen economic governance in the euro area, on this issue, there is political consensus among the European political leaders. The current proposals are, in the view of the ECB, a step in the right direction, but so far fail to constitute the necessary quantity for euro area countries. And as to macroeconomic surveillance, it is of paramount importance that the procedure has a clear focus on those countries which pose the most serious threat to the smooth functioning of economic and monetary union. And these are, at the present experience shows, countries with large and persistent current account deficits, significant accumulated losses in competitiveness, and high levels of private and public sector indebtedness. Moreover, the procedures should be quasi-automatic, limiting excessive political interference in the process. And furthermore, it would be useful to have more gradual application of financial sanctions to provide clear incentives for appropriate macroeconomic policies. Let me conclude, ladies and gentlemen, policymakers in individual euro area countries have to come to terms with the realities of being part of a monetary union. Some loss of sovereignty is part of the reality of sharing and benefiting from this common currency. And if this is not acknowledged in time, it may imply an even larger loss of sovereignty at a later stage.
Дълговата криза с основание се свързва с Гърция, но тя не е изключително гръцка, а европейска. Еврозоната има механизми, разбира се, никога не са били тествани до такава степен и в такава дълбочина, както сега. Рискът е политически, защото действително Европейския съюз е уникално създание с икономики, които много зависят една от друга и едновременно с това с много силни и уважавани национални политики. Тоест, как може това да се преведе на езика на единството, когато сме в криза, това предстои да видим. Това ще бъде един тест за и политически, не говоря само икономически, защото да кажем, че сме солидарни, че се подкрепяме в добри времена, не е трудно, но в лоши е истинско предизвикателство. Затова и политиката вътре в страните, националистическите течения, които все повече вземат територия в европейските страни, безспорно е един за сега не отговорен въпрос. Знаете, че всяка страна всъщност може да блокира спасяването на практика на целия Европейски съюз през европейската помощ. Тъй, че общественото мнение вътре в страните, ние говорим за политика в изключително активна медийна среда. Привличането на общественото мнение, обясняването, ние имаме нужда от знаещи хора, за да могат да преценят за себе си до какво би довело, ако Европейския съюз или европейската монетарна политика претърпят регрес, претърпят обратно развитие. Много трудно време, действително. Поставени са на изпитание почти всички политики в Европейския съюз и то малко преди финалната подготовка за следващата финансова рамка. Нещо, което аз казах и в моята лекция. Страните, които изпитват най-големи трудности сега, са така наречените кохезионни страни.
тези, които всъщност получиха най-много пари от Европейския съюз. Вероятно, това ще бъде центъра и на дебата по финансовата рамка. Изводи трябва да се направят.
Европейската политика по дълговата криза получи критики и то отдясно.
Нова демократия ήταν ανέκαθεν ένα κόμμα με πολύ έντονο ευρωπαϊκό προσανατολισμό. Σας θυμίζω ότι η Νέα Δημοκρατία υπέγραψε και την ένταξη της Ελλάδος στην τότε Ευρωπαϊκή Οικονομική Κοινότητα. Πιστεύουμε πάρα πολύ στο ρόλο της Ευρώπης, πιστεύουμε στην έννοια της ευρωπαϊκής αλληλεγγύης. Σε αυτά τα πλαίσια, μηχανισμοί όπως το ευρωομόλογο, που συζητείται ήδη ευρέως, το οποίο θα επιτρέψει στην Ευρώπη να εκμεταλλευτεί το μέγεθός της, είναι προτάσεις πολύ σημαντικές, που αυτή τη στιγμή ευτυχώς έχουν αρχίσει να συζητούνται και ευελπιστώ ότι τα επόμενα χρόνια θα μπουν πιο έντονα στην ατζέντα. Ως προς τον Ευρωπαϊκό Μηχανισμό Στήριξης σίγουρα δείχνει την απόλυτη απόφαση της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης να στηρίξει όλα τα κράτη-μέλη της Ευρωζώνης. Έχουμε εκφράσει μια συγκεκριμένη αμφιβολία κατά πόσο η συμμετοχή ιδιωτών στο ρίσκο των ομολόγων, όπως αυτή έχει εκφραστεί μέχρι στιγμής στον Ευρωπαϊκό Μηχανισμό Στήριξης, θα επιτρέψει τελικά τα κράτη-μέλη, τα ασθενέστερα κράτη-μέλη οικονομικά, να ξαναβγούν στις αγορές ή θα τα αναγκάσει τελικά να προσφύγουν στο μηχανισμό, κάτι που με κάποια άλλη διατύπωση θα μπορούσαν να είχαν αποφύγει.
Η Ευρώπη πιέζει τα ελληνικά κόμματα να υπάρχει κάτι σαν πολιτικό κονσένσους, σαν πολιτική συνένεση. Τι είναι η απάντηση της Νέας Δημοκρατίας?
Το κρίσιμο ερώτημα είναι να υπάρξει λύση στο δημοσιονομικό πρόβλημα της χώρας. Και αυτή τη στιγμή βλέπουμε ότι δεν κινούμαστε στη σωστή κατεύθυνση. Γιατί αν κινούμαστε στη σωστή κατεύθυνση, δεν θα είχαμε όλη αυτή τη συζήτηση. Η Ευρώπη αυτή τη στιγμή εκφράζει μια αγωνία για την εξέλιξη του προγράμματος, όχι λόγω της τάσης αντιπολίτευσης, αλλά λόγω των επιδόσεων της κυβέρνησης στην εκτέλεση του προγράμματος, αλλά κυρίως, κατά τη δικιά μας άποψη, και την ίδια τη στρατηγική που είχε το πρόγραμμα. Το ερώτημα είναι να δώσουμε συνένεση σε τι, σε κάτι που θεωρούμε ότι δεν λειτουργεί. Εμείς κάναμε κάτι πιο υπεύθυνο. Από τη μία, δεν εμποδίσαμε την κυβέρνηση σε καμία περίπτωση να εκτελέσει το πρόγραμμα. Δεν βγήκαμε στους δρόμους όπως έκανε παλιά το Πασόκ όταν η Νέα Δημοκρατία ήταν κυβέρνηση, προσπαθώντας να σταματήσει όλες τις διαρθρωτικές μεταρρυθμίσεις. Αλλά παράλληλα, καταθέσαμε την πρόταση που σας εξήγησα πριν, με συγκεκριμένα νούμερα, συγκεκριμένα στοιχεία. Μια πρόταση που επιτυγχάνει τους στόχους του προγράμματος δημοσιονομικής πειθαρχίας καλύτερα και ταχύτερα. Άρα νομίζω ότι έχουμε θέσει μια ρεαλιστική βάση για συζήτηση.
И ако изходът от гръцката икономическа криза все още изглежда неясен, необходимото условие за него изкристализира.
Ако Гърция приложи всички договорени с надзорната тройка мерки, тя ще се превърне в една от най-силните страни в еврозоната. Ако не го направи, катастрофата е неизбежна. Това според икономистите е дилемата пред страната.